That has got to be one of the best intros in video game history. Something that Rare has a pretty good knack for, actually, that I just thought about. Because, like, they had a pretty kick-ass intro for this game. Banjo-Kazooie is a really memorable one with that intro. And who could forget the DK rap of Donkey Kong 64? I mean, really now. So, with that, welcome to Let's Play Donkey Kong Country for the Super Nintendo. I'm playing this on my virtual console, on my Wii. And I am pumped up to get started on this, let me tell you. So right here we have the player modes right away. I guess I might as well explain them. This will of course be a one-player game, but I'll just get this explanation out of the way so I don't have to do it for the other two projects. Two-player contest is basically where you have two different sets of Donkey Kong and Diddy Kong, and you basically race with a friend to see who can beat the game the fastest, or who gets the most bonus areas, or whatever other criteria you want. And a two-player team is just one set of Donkey and Diddy, and you basically have one player plays as Donkey Kong, and then once he dies, the second player takes over and plays as Diddy Kong. That's basically how that works. But again, because I don't have any friends, I'm going to play one player. I mean, after all, I am sitting alone on a Friday night recording myself playing video games instead of partying. But, yeah, I mean, it's no wonder I don't have any friends. Okay, I'm kidding. I'm kidding. That's kind of a dark note at the start of the episode. Believe me, I do have a social life. It may not seem like it, but I do. But I was just... you can't blame me. I was super psyched to record this game, because I just love this game and this series in general. I am pumped to do this series of projects. Because again, to explain to people who don't know, I do plan on doing all four of the Donkey Kong Country games in a row. 1, 2, 3, and Returns all the way through. And yeah, that's very exciting for me because I'm also doing this series alongside my Skyward Sword 6-heart run. And I gotta admit, this is prop... No. 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 You did not just do that. You couldn't have just done that. That didn't just happen, did it? That didn't... Fuck. Just fucking me in the... Oh my god, that's gonna set the tone for the entire LP, isn't it? Dying on the first enemy. Tradition, I guess. Okay, let me switch characters here. So I'm gonna switch to Diddy Kong because his roll jump is a little bit better. At the beginning of this first level, you can get quite a few one-ups, actually. I just got one from the treehouse. That's the one that everyone should know about. And then if you go across the trees here and do some nice roll jumps, you can get a few more. The red balloons are worth one life. We're gonna get a green balloon here. Those are worth two lives. So let me do some explanation before I kind of get back to the topic that I was talking about earlier, before I was really interrupted by the first enemy of the game. I need to talk about the character differences here. I might as well do some intro for the... this is part one. I do realize this is an overdone game, and everyone probably knows everything about this game. I just lost my teammate, which is going to completely neglect what I was going to talk about. Well, let's just do it anyway without Diddy. So, the difference between Donkey and Diddy is Donkey Kong is more powerful. He has more authority as far as taking out enemies. Like, these enemies over here, they're called clumps, and only Donkey Kong can take these out with the jumps. Diddy can take these out with the rolls, but only Donkey can take them out with actually jumping on them. So, we'll be seeing that a lot throughout the game. Certain enemies can only be taken out by Donkey Kong by jumping on them, and I'll explain more about that as we encounter new enemies. This is Rambi. This is the first animal buddy who is probably the most iconic one of the series. And this is our first bonus stage. In order to get 100% in this game, you need to find all of the bonus stages hidden throughout the actual levels. The number of bonus areas varies depending on the level. Some levels don't even have bonus areas, and I think I actually might have missed one. You're not going to miss a bonus area in the first... I mean, okay, I gotta say this right now, I gotta get this off my chest. I am actually not going to 100% this game, that's not in the plan. I guess that does need some explanation of why I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to 100% this one, just because there isn't much of a reward for doing it. I do plan on 100%ing 2, 3, and Returns, so don't worry about that. But I don't plan on 100%ing this one because there's not a reward for it. In 2, 3, and Returns, there's an incentive to do it because going for 100% unlocks extra levels to play, which is something that I definitely encourage and something that I would like to do. So I definitely do want to play the extra bonus levels in the other three games and see what that's all about. But in this game, there's nothing. There's no reward at all for 100%, which is kind of a shame. But that's kind of a demonstration of how the series develops and improves on this game. I will admit this right now, and some people are probably going to hate me for this. This is probably my least favorite of the series. I still love the game to death, but it is my least favorite of the series, and it's really just because it's like, just comparing it to the other games, underdeveloped, which is understandable because it is the first game in the series. And yeah, that's pretty much all I mean, what else can I really say to describe why this game is my favorite, why it's my least favorite? There are a few quote-unquote problems I have with the game now that I have played the other three. I will say that the level design is really weird, and I will point that out once we get to the weirder levels. But yeah, I'll talk about that later. Let me go back to the subject, actually, of Donkey Kong being more powerful than Diddy Kong. You might have noticed me taking out those armadillo-type enemies. Let's see if I can find another one. There are a lot of those in this level. There's a checkpoint. The star barrels are checkpoints, in case you didn't know that. Okay, here's one right here. So you can see they're rolling around and such. With Diddy Kong, let me show Diddy Kong. If you... fucking rope. Damn it! Ah, the stupid banana got me... killed. Okay, well, I'll just explain it. I don't really need to show it. With Diddy Kong... well, damn it! Are you serious? I'm getting killed by the dumbest things. Like, this is the worst representation of my skill with this game. I'm a lot better at this game than what I'm showing. Though I will say this is probably the game that I'm the worst at, too. So that's another reason why it's probably my least favorite. But, okay, again... jeez. Stop it! Okay, so, when these things are rolling around, Donkey Kong can take them out in one shot. As you probably have been noticing. But Diddy Kong... he needs to jump on him twice. He needs to jump on him once to stun him, then he needs to jump on him again to finish him off. When they're in the mode, when they're not rolling around and they're just kind of standing there, Diddy can take him out in one hit. So that's all I was really trying to show there. It probably wasn't worth the death to, in the process of showing that off, but oh well. Okay, so again, I don't really plan on getting 100%, but I'm gonna try to do the best of my ability doing so. I know there's at some point there's a bonus barrel, like there's this barrel that's gonna shoot you into a bonus area, like down below the level here, when you're swinging across the vines. Damn it. See, the key to these games, and I'm gonna be mentioning this a lot, is it's best to always just keep moving. That's the best way to get through some of the obstacles, and just like the way the patterns work, if you keep moving, you should be able to get through all the obstacles. I'm going to try to demonstrate that a little bit better and demonstrate my actual skill with the game, because I haven't really done a good job of that right now. So, first two levels done. I'm not really going to waste much time at the... Kong friend places like Cranky. All Cranky really does is just give you advice and chastise you. I might show that later, but right now I just... I kind of just want to jump right into the gameplay and explain as much as I can. Again, I realize this is a super overdone game, and a lot of you probably are quite familiar with it, but still, it gets me into the flow of the LP by actually explaining the game. So, I just want to get it all over with in part one, so I can actually focus on the game in later episodes. So, what to talk about next? I was on a subject on this series in general being one of my favorite game series of all time, and it really is. I mean, it's a very close second behind the Zelda series, and I'm really excited about this series of LPs I'm doing in general right here, because again, I'm doing the DKC series alongside Skyward Sword, the Six Heart Run, and I'm expecting this to be the most exciting period of LPing that I'm gonna have on my channel. I really am just pumped up about this. And this kind of reminds me of when I did Wind Waker and Donkey Kong 64 side by side. That was a lot of fun too. But I'm gonna have a lot of fun with this. Again, I can't gush in awe enough about this series. Get used to my gushing and awing. I'm gonna be doing a lot of gushing and just like nerdgasming over this series, especially when I get to 2. Again, 2. 2 is my favorite game of the series, and it's probably actually my favorite video game of all time. It's very close with Zelda: A Link to the Past on Super Nintendo. So, yep. So, okay, these coins here, I should have explained this. You might notice me picking up these animal coins, and they're really not that important. Actually, I'm not going to talk about them. Never mind. I talk about them when I collect 3. Like, whenever you collect 3 of the same kind, something special will happen, but I don't really want to get into it right now. So, let's just keep going. Decoral Capers. This is going to be our first water level that we are actually going to save for next time on Let's Play Donkey Kong Country. Thank you guys for watching. This has been Mike127, and I will see you in the first water level. Peace out, everyone.